So now we're just on the way to my striking coach, Kyle Keane, in KC Fight Base. So on the way there now, we're going to get there for about 10:30, hip pads for half an hour, 45 minutes with Kyle, just to start the day off, just get nice and loose, because it's got quite a busy day today. Yeah, so on the way there now. Striking. I feel like all round, really, to be honest, everyone else I see in the UK, especially in my division, striking, I just feel like I can just pick them apart, to be honest, on the feet. It's quite funny how I started training with Kyle. I've been onto him, I've known him for a few years, because obviously I'd done striking when I was a kid, and then I've always been onto the striking gym that he runs, KC Fight Base, when I used to do Thai myself, but I'd done it in another gym when I was younger. But I actually fought a lad who fought out of their gym. There's a lad, Charlie, I fought him. He still fights out of KC Fight Base, but we're both out of there now as well. So I fought him just over a year ago. After I fought him, because I'd already seen Kyle and I thought I'd like to get in some work with him and stuff like that. But then I also knew there was like Charlie, for instance, like he was around my weight, and I thought like it's almost inevitable that we're gonna fight one day. So as soon as that fight got out of the way, I just messaged Kyle and just started getting in with him, and then been doing it ever since, really, twice a week.
One. If you hit him with that, yeah, forever my best mate. Right.
There we are.
Nice.
Good.
Good. I'm
going to
go inside, low kick after that, yeah. Boom, boom, boom. You're
going to
step it out.
Yeah, the striking. I feel like my striking has came on major since I've been working with them on like the pads and stuff like that. I feel like, because for a while when I done, when I moved to MMA, or I was still doing striking and aspiring and stuff like that as well, but I feel like I lost like my touch on it, almost, because I have neglected it at first. Like I was saying before, I don't like to neglect it now, but at first I half did, because I had so much to catch up on with my grappling. They wanted to match me striking, so I neglected it, and I felt like my striking was I wasn't keeping up. I still felt like I was a good level, but now that I'm on top of my striking as well, I feel so much better for it. So yeah.
One, boom. Good, that's it, covering everything, yeah. One, boom. And again. One, boom. Good.
Yeah, so I've just finished my striking session then with Kyle. Feeling sharp, my legs are on fire, feeling great. Now I'm on my way to my strength conditioning coaches, Femi and Danny. So that's in Aspire, so I'm just driving from KC now to Aspire for my second session of the day. It's 11:30, so started two sessions before 12 o'clock. Yeah, so this is going to be a tough session. I don't mind the weights part, but we do something at the end called conditioning, which you're going to see as well, and that's horrible. It's it's hard work, like, but this is my last one of this camp. I've been doing it for like 11 weeks now, so this is my final push today on this, ready for the fight next week.
Since the start, since we were here, yeah. 3 years. Three and a half years, near enough. Coming up to 2, yeah.
Has he been fighting here for 3 years or training?
Yeah.
So might have been training a little bit longer. So when we took over about 3 years ago, he was just young, weren't he, at the time?
Yeah, he was proper young, he was like a baby.
Didn't have much experience with what we do. So we just built him up from scratch, really. Built the foundations up, and as you can see now, that the athlete he is, the shape he's in, you know what I mean, like, it speaks for itself. So yeah, about 3 years since we've known him, and we've been working with him ever since we come to the gym. Over the past year, this is the most we've seen him like really, really focused on improving his craft, you know, improving his strength, improving his physical capabilities, improving his skills on the mat. And as you can see, there, he goes, just gives everything every single time he trains.
The thing with Dunny as well, he's naturally athletic anyway, in terms of like power output. And he was anyway, we're just adding to that even more, which is even better, do you know what I mean? Like, his numbers are through the roof each camp. He just keeps improving those numbers in terms of his lifts, his power output, and then the condition numbers as well. Like, you can see there, you see him going for on the treadmill there, like getting 25s and stuff. And even towards the end, he's getting like 31 kilometres. Even after he's fatigued, after doing all them rounds, that's 4 rounds in. And then, yeah, he wants to do an extra round as well.
Pro debut on the same card as Jack in the 15th of April.
Are you excited for your upcoming fights?
Oh, yeah.
How do you think Jack's going to be?
He's going to smash it. Me and him have we're best mates. We're always saying together, always doing stuff together. So like, our training is together. So I've seen everything and he's seen everything from me. So I know we've left no stone unturned. So it's going to be good.
Has he been putting in the work here?
Oh yeah. Look at him now, look at him go. he's always putting in the work, he's always here when I'm here, and I'm always here, and we're always doing our conditioning together, training and sparring and all that together, so I see everything, and he's as ready as he'll ever be, as am I.
Speaking on his upcoming fight, do you think he's ready, seeing what you see today?
More than ready.
Yeah, I'd say so, yeah. Like, we just going back to what I said then, his numbers are better again, so just that's what it's about each camp for all of these, just improving the numbers. in terms of strength, power, conditioning. That's where the foundation always begins for us, to start the camp. And then we look to build on them numbers. So do things like running speed, watts, even the number of reps you can do in terms of like med ball slams and all stuff like that. So yeah, he's just slowly progressing each camp. And he's going to probably keep doing that.
Yeah, I've never seen him like this before. Like, in the zone. Fist, I've probably seen him.
Adding your like suction cup things on your back.
Oh yeah. Yeah, these are just off my one of my sponsors. I have a Concordia clinic. It's like a clinic I go to, I get massages. They have oxygen chambers, they have cryotherapy, they have everything. So I can just go there when I want, really, get looked after. I go twice a week, really, get two massages, one off Rob and one off John. So that's like another boss sponsor I have, helped me just like being able to train to the extent that I do. So yeah, with these cups on my back, these aren't like, they're not, I'm not injured or nothing. They're just like, just a word, just like keeping me up to scratch sort of thing. They're not like just injury preventing rather than treating an injury. So yeah, it's just good.
As well, like, it's not, we're more than a gym, yeah, you know, we're like a big family and that, you know what I mean? We are, we're more than a gym. You know, when we're going down to shows, you have people coming down who aren't fighting, they're coming down there to warm up other fighters, you know what I mean? Like the likes of, you know, anyone, people will come down to watch the team, will come down to help each other warm up, we'll go out and support each other everywhere we can. And you know, as you've been there today, you can just feel the vibes and the energy we've got in here, you know what I mean? It's like we are a huge family, all of us. We are, like, we've all got each other's backs and we always will, and that, so that's why I think we're doing something special, and I'm just made up to be a part of it, really. I'm hands in the game at the minute, you know, he just puts people down with that.
Yeah.
If you look through his past fights, the amount of finishes he's got, it speaks for himself. His conditioning,
his technique,
everything that he's doing now. I put him in there, they're definitely within our top three in the gym at the minute, 100%.
So I just finished strength conditioning then, and now we just drove to my meal prep sponsor, Goodness Grill, pick up my meals for today and tomorrow. So we're just outside now, so we'll go in and take a look at some of the plans. Alright. So just picking up my meals now. I've got I got two meals a day off them. I've got peri peri chicken with rice. Fights not this Saturday, next Saturday. Yeah. So I've got peri peri chicken with rice, and I've got teriyaki steak and noodles. Lovely. Make sure I'm eating nice.
What's your favourite?
Probably the teriyaki steak and noodles, to be honest. Yeah, it's gotta be. was like, in my first couple of fights and that, because obviously the dieting's like one of the hardest parts about it. I used to like not feel my sessions and have like loads of food, and I got in at night just because of cravings and stuff like that. But I've got a nutritionist now and stuff like, and he helps me with stuff like that. So I prefer to fuel my sessions now, so I'm not really bothered if I'm too hungry later. It's just I'm half used to it now, to be honest. So I prefer to fuel my sessions so I get the most out of them, rather than going into my sessions done in, just because I'm trying to save myself for later to eat more. You know what I mean? So I just prefer to make sure I'm at 100% in all my training sessions. I'll try to be anyway, but fucking saying that much, your body just fatigues no matter how much you eat. You know what I mean? When you train the way I've been training for this fight.
What food are you missing most during this camp?
I love chocolate. Chocolate, crisps. I'm not really a sweet kind of guy, you know, like all Haribo and that, like that Star Mix and all that. I'm not really into all that. Yeah. I just give me like a bar of chocolate with just like crisps. I'm more of a chocolate than crisp guy. And I like pizza, burgers. Mainly pizza though, to be honest. Yeah, so it's around 10 past six. I'm just on my way to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Tonight it'll be about 6:30 until about 8:00. This is like my last proper Jiu-Jitsu session. I'll do just Jiu-Jitsu. Obviously, I've got MMA the rest of the week and stuff like that, but just solely Jiu-Jitsu. This will be the last one at camp, really. So get there about 6:30, last session of the day.
What have you been up to in between S&C and this?
Well, I went home, got home about 2:00, 3:00, and I was planning on having a nap, but didn't end up happening. I ended up just chilling, watching Netflix and that, but I'm half paying for it now, like I'm feeling it. Probably should have had a nap. But.
Is there anything in particular you want to work on this last proper BJJ session?
Nah, not really. It's not necessarily the techniques in the class that I'm doing. It's mainly just I want to just get my last rolling rounds out now. Just get a few good rounds in, a rolling. That's the main objective for this session. Obviously, I'll be learning stuff in the technique and that, but my main goal for the session is to just get a good few rolls in. I'm not really too bothered. I'm not going to be too hard on myself, I would do either, to be honest. Just about getting them done now. Just getting the last ones out the way. Yeah, probably be quite busy, like. Will be. When I'm this close to a fight, I prefer to be quite quiet. But I don't know, I'm not really bothered, to be honest. As long as I like it when I've got like Liam in or someone like to train with. Sometimes on the nights it's a bit hit and miss, like some nights I won't do the jits because I'm done in. So if some fighters are like fatigued and or like they haven't got fights and stuff like that, for instance, if one of my teammates hasn't got a fight and they don't want to do the jits in the night because they want to rest and they don't have to, it leaves you without a partner then. So, but hopefully there'll be someone like. Yeah, Liam McCracken.
Yeah, Damien
Femi
said you guys were quite close.
Yeah, he's like my big brother. He has been tough. He took me under his wing when I was like 15, 16, and he was like my age now. So he was in like my position the way I am now, where like fighting for like titles and being talked about as one of the best in the UK and stuff like that as an amateur. And I was just like a young kid, and he just took me under his wing.
But like, you've improved a lot, hasn't
he? Yeah, 100%. He pushes me, and he's such a high level. He can just teach me loads as well as filling me in every day. But he's boss, yeah.
Hey,
good to be offloading your training a little bit?
Yeah, it does, yeah. I feel like my body's asking for it now. Like, I've put my body through hell for months, training all the time, training as much as I can, every day, really. I think I can't remember when last time I had a day off. I train up Saturdays and Sundays, like spar Sundays. Like, I can't remember the last time I had a proper day off. So body's looking forward to next week, like, just chilling out, losing the last bit of weight. But yeah, this is the final push.
How are you going so far?
Yeah, it's gone good. I'm about four six minute rolls in. So that's like four sixes. Rolling, constant, feeling fit as fuck, like, I can't gas, it's impossible. When you've fucking been saying this hard, your gas tanks through the roof, I can't gas, like, not even breathing, Eddie. It's just like, feeling good, feeling great. Obviously, I'm expecting it to go to the floor at some point. And then, the work that I've been putting in, me grappling will show, you know what I mean? Yeah, so I'm expecting a good fight, I'm expecting to go everywhere, to be honest, but it's like all the hard work I've been putting on, it's going to show everywhere, you know what I mean? So I'm sure what happens. Expect everything.
Do you identify any strengths?
I've not watched that much of him.
You've done a lot of analysis?
No, I've not watched that much on him. I've seen he's alright on the feet. But I'd have seen one of his fights, only one I could find on YouTube, apart from the one I've seen already. He was fighting some lad from Poland, but he didn't look that good, the lad, like. And he ended up taking him down and stopping him with strikes, but I don't know, the lad looked like he didn't have no answers for him when he was on bottom, so yeah, I don't know, I just like, when I watch people fight, it's like, When I watch him fight on YouTube and that, I was thinking, like, yeah, he looks good, but he's not fighting me, you know what I mean? You know, he looks good against someone else, but he's not fighting me, you know what I mean? So, just try not to look too much into it, to be honest. And just turn up and do what I do. Yeah, so, just finished jiu-jitsu then, on our way home. So, just went 8 o'clock then. So, I've been training for an hour and a half tonight. Got a good few rolls in, feeling great. Me cardio is through the roof. I'm excited for next week. Now I'd start from, like, I've got another hard day tomorrow and another hard day Friday probably, and then I'll start proper tapering off then for the fight. Just like let my body recover off everything I've put it through. Just ready to peak on fight night. So I'm just as sharp as I can be. Yeah, so that's it. That's a day in the life of Jack Dunne. Good few sessions in. Went to the KC in the morning. It pads with me striking coach Kyle. Then went straight to S&C. Weight, power. And then went and done me conditioning, which is probably seeing, which is that conditioning that I've done today that you've seen on the video is probably one of my hardest sessions of the week. Obviously I've got sparring and stuff like that, but sparring is my job, I enjoy it. Doing conditioning is not my job and I hate it. So we done that, went home, rested, and then went back tonight and got done what needs to be done for the fight. But I'm feeling great, feeling happy. What I love to do.
What sort of emotions do you feel in the final week?
Nerves, excited, nervous. It's like a roller coaster. It's, you know, you're excited 1 minute, nervous the next. But as I always say it, it's just the only reason I'd ever get nervous is because how bad I want to win. I'm not nervous about this lad. I know on my day, if I perform to my best on my day. It's no competition. I have beat anyone that they're gonna put in front of me at the minute on my day. When you're a fighter, every decision that you make goes towards the fight. It's not it's your life. It's and if it's not your life, you can't half-ass it. You're in the wrong career. Like, I hate it sometimes, but then it's just what I feel like I've been born to do. Like, even I wake up in the morning, sometimes I can't be arsed going to get punched in the face at 9:30 in the morning. You know what I mean? But I just know this is what I'm here to do, and it's not going to change. That's the only thing I'd get nervous about, is not performing to your best. But I think every fighter does that, but a lot of them lie and say they don't get nervous and stuff like that, but they're lying, or they just don't want it bad enough, well, as bad as me anyway. Not many people do, I'll tell you that. But yeah, so that's a day in the life. Been good, really enjoyed it.
Get a win?
Yeah, you will get a win.